Blood in the body circulates to transport products and to transport waste.
Yeah, come on.
They can't move around by themselves, and so the bloodstream takes them where they gotta go.
Yeah, that's right. Blood is a tissue all its own. The river of life is how it's known. It flows through the body in vessels named arteries, capillaries, and veins. When the heart contracts in systole, blood flows through elastic arteries. They transport blood away from the heart towards each and every body part.
The blood moves
through smaller arteries, then arterioles, then capillaries
that lie close to cell membranes,
where substances are interchanged. The capillary blood's then drained into venules and larger veins. It flows to the heart, and as it flows, it can't flow backwards. The vein valves close.
Follow along as I describe how the bloodstream is utilized to transport products and help regulate homeostasis or a steady state. Blood in the body circulates to transport products and to transport waste.
Come on.
They can move around by themselves.
No.
And so the bloodstream takes them where they gotta go.
Where they gotta go.
The heart pumps blood throughout the body, 5 liters per minute
approximately. It's made of plasma, and as well clotting factors, platelets, and blood cells. Plasma's the fluid in the bloodstream that's mostly water and proteins. It transports blood cells, and it's replete with platelets, nutrients, and heat.
The plasma in our blood is derived from foods and what our diets provide. The blood cells and platelets originate
in red bone marrow, as the need dictates.
The red bone marrow makes them specialized multipotent stem cells, which give rise to red cells, white cells, and additionally megakaryocytes, or MKCs. Platelets are made in the marrow as well, but they're not classified as true cells. They're fragments of megakaryocytes, which help the blood clot and bleeding sites. Blood in the body circulates.
Yeah, come on.
To transport products and to transport waste.
Come on.
They can't move around by themselves.
No.
And so the bloodstream takes them where they gotta go.
The white blood cells of the WBCs are core leukocytes. Collectively, they defend the body and help it fight pathogenic microbes and parasites.
The red blood cells, or the RBCs, are called erythrocytes. Technically, they're small disc-like biconcave cells which lack a nucleus and other organelles.
They're mostly made of hemoglobin, which transports O2 or oxygen. The oxygen is obtained, in fact, from the lungs, alveoli, or air sacs.
When O2 and hemoglobin bind, the blood turns bright red, and keep in mind, it flows to the left heart and out as well to deliver oxygen to the cells.
The blood also eliminates CO2 that tissues generate. It flows from the tissues to the right heart, then to the lung, where CO2 departs.
Blood in the body circulates.
Come on.
To transport products and to transport waste.
Yeah.
They can move around by themselves.
No. Organs in the body rely on an optimal blood supply, so the bloodstream interacts constantly with every system in the body.
It transports the products of digestion,
yeah,
from the fillet of the small intestine,
yeah,
to the liver, where they're metabolized, then to tissues, where they're utilized.
The blood indeed works hand in hand with the body's ductless endocrine gland. It transports hormones the glands secrete to the target tissues that they seek. The bloodstream also circulates
urea and other nitrogenous waste.
Yeah.
They're received and filtered by the kidneys,
woo,
then eliminated from the body.
Yeah.
The body circulates
Come on.
To transport.